Episode 9 is said to have many different emotional sequences in the movie by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, one aspect of Episode 9 that I personally am really interested in seeing is exactly how J.J. Abrams is going to use some of the original trilogy characters in Episode 9 in order to create a new storyline for the characters of Kylo Ren, Rey, you name it. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film when it comes to some of the set leaks, the set designs, the concept art and storyboard descriptions, etc. One of which has all to do with the character of Rey and, of course, Han Solo in Episode 9. Specifically, a description of Rey on board of the Millennium Falcon with R2-D2 behind her, where it's described that R2 is tapping into the framework of the Millennium Falcon, where R2 discovers a hidden message of Han Solo that was recorded many years ago. It's described to be a recording of Han Solo talking about his son Ben Solo and his concern of his anger and the path that he is going down. Another goes over Han trying to reach out to Leia, expressing his fear of his time alone with Luke at the training temple. It said that this was the foundation of what split both Han and Leia apart, were of course different views of the state of Ben Solo's place in the galaxy. It's described that R2 is going through the different bits of messages that eventually leads to a terrifying one of Leia reaching out to Han, delivering the news of what Ben Solo did to Luke's Jedi students and his training temple. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this and as to why this sounds like it's going to be one of the most emotional scenes in Star Wars history. Now, first things first, I really want to go over the whole entire aspect of Han Solo and Ben Solo. Now, we do know that J.J. Abrams is trying to create a more in-depth relationship between father and son in Episode 9. Bringing back that family element to the Star Wars universe is always a good thing in my opinion. Now, the Millennium Falcon, I am sure it has many secret messages in there, and R2-D2 is actually said to be tapping into the framework. I guess when he uses that little tool and connects it into the console of the Falcon and goes through everything. Now, to my knowledge, I'm honestly not even quite sure if the Falcon was able to ever record messages or signals going out to other individuals across the galaxy. I guess that J.J. Abrams is going to be introducing this in Episode 9. So the first message, or the bit of a message, of Han Solo, alright, consists of himself actually expressing his concern to Leia about Ben Solo's anger and the path that he is going down and how there's too much Vader within him. The other of which is, of course, Han Solo expressing concern as well about Ben Solo's time alone with Luke Skywalker, his very own uncle that is actually estranged at the time. So you can really see that Han Solo actually did in fact care for Ben. It's not like he fully neglected him, but we do know that in a lot of canon material, that's how Ben Solo viewed things, that he was neglected by both Leia and Han Solo. And that is the absolute truth, is that Han Solo did his own smuggling business, some racing stuff here and there, and Leia did her political stuff, and that's exactly why Kylo Ren / Ben Solo became very confused as a child about who he really is and his place in the galaxy. So the last bit is, I think, the most, I guess you could say, the most bone-chilling moment that you could ever hear for, you know, Han Solo as a character, through the words of Leia reaching out to Han Solo about what Ben Solo did to Luke Skywalker's A New Generation of Jedi and his Jedi training temple, essentially delivering the news that Ben Solo turned against Luke Skywalker. Now, from the previous actual leak details that we went over, I believe it was 4 months ago, give or take, is that we actually do know that Luke Skywalker eventually delivers the news to Leia, and now hence we can see how Han Solo gets the news from, of course, Leia herself, is of course through the actual radio transmission or whatever it really is in the Star Wars universe, delivering the news to Han Solo remotely through the Millennium Falcon, and all of these are stored within the actual ship itself. I didn't know that was an actual thing in the Star Wars universe, within the actual Falcon itself. So, like I say, we do know that J.J. Abrams wants to create all these different emotional sequences in the movie that are truly going to hit fans' hearts, that'll keep people talking for years on end. And like I say, I mean, when we think about emotional scenes in the Star Wars sequel trilogy, by far, I think, you know, one of the biggest ones of all is, of course, the death of Han Solo. That really got a lot of people talking about that for years. And it seems as though that J.J. Abrams is trying to create more emotional moments like this in, of course, the Star Wars franchise. We do know that this movie is going to actually shed a lot of tears, as we have heard, you know, even in the teaser trailer, a lot of bits here and there are going to shed some tears. And that's, of course, tears of sadness of what they're going to actually include in there. So it only makes one wonder what the tone of this movie really is going to be like. We do know that parts of the film are going to be darker than that of Revenge of the Sith, and that to me speaks volumes. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night.